coming home from school, look quite content with life. Daughter has changed from school clothes to something more festive. Dressing a little makes her feel and look more charming. Mother, too, changes from her daytime clothes. The women of this family seem to feel that they owe it to the men of the family to look relaxed, rested, and attractive at dinner time. Now, mother and daughter put the finishing touches on the dinner. Father, too, looks forward to this date with the family. He has had a hard day at the office, and in his briefcase are some contracts which must be looked over tonight. But in the meantime, he will relax at dinner with those he loves. These boys greet their dad as though they are genuinely glad to see him, as though they had really missed being away from him during the day and are anxious to talk to him. This is the time for pleasant discussion in a thoroughly relaxed mood. They don't pick this time of the day to spring unpleasant surprises on Dad, and this is no time to dun Father for a raise in your allowance, new clothes, or argue about other financial matters. Ah, dinner time. The dinner date has begun, and they're all happy about it. Napkins on the lap, the family awaits service. They converse pleasantly while Dad serves. I said pleasantly, for that is the keynote at dinner time. It is not only good manners, but good sense. Pleasant, unemotional conversation helps digestion. Father serves mother first, then daughter, then the boys. Don't worry, fellas, you won't get left. No one starts eating until Father has served himself. Always wait for the hostess, in this case mother, to begin eating before you start. Tell mother how good the food is. Maybe sis rates a compliment too. It makes them want to continue pleasing you. Well, all this is good general advice, but there are some specific don'ts. Maybe the family will demonstrate for us. Don't monopolize the conversation and go on and on without stopping. Nothing destroys the charm of a meal more quickly. To say that the rest of the group is bored would be a gross understatement. Don't discuss unpleasant topics such as gruesome sights or sounds. The dinner table is no place for discontent. It makes Dad and Mother uncomfortable and unhappy. Don't insult your brother or sister with offensive remarks about friends. Arguments, harsh words, mean tension and distress for everyone. Do remember simply this. With your own family, you can relax. Be yourself. Just be sure it's your best self. When the dinner hour at home is treated with a certain amount of graciousness and ceremony, it can be memorable. There is no family so poor but that the evening meal can be eaten in an atmosphere of warmth and gentleness. There is no family so busy but that it can come together in the evening for a dinner date which will give its members something to look back upon with happiness all their days.
Yeah. things enough for bad. They can really make you mad.
His mom slowly
other things
cuts.
Just make you swell and curse. When you're chewing on life's gristle, that glamble, give a whistle. And this'll help things turn out for the best. And always look
you're here.
The bright side of life. Always look on
sorry.
The bright side.
No, sorry.
We can't
sorry.
This.
If life seems jolly rotten, there's something you forgot. And that's to laugh and smile and dance and sing. When you're feeling in the dumps, don't be silly chumps. Just purse your lips and whistle. That's the thing.
Wait, what happened?
And always look on the bright side of life. Come on. Always look on the bright side of life.
Oh my god, that was funny.
That was awesome.
When you're in the World Cup and all your hopes are up,
No one said acting was fun. They always say, oh, look, you get to eat all this food. Dave, stop.
Cheer up. Next time, always look on the bright side.
And wait.
Wait.